respected artists and guests from Bangladesh, colleagues, friends, and everyone present in this auditorium today, I welcome you all on the behalf of the Council for Social Development and India International Center. IIC and CSD are sister organizations, and we often join hands for organizing seminars and conferences on issues of social concern. But today, we are here for a little different reason, and this time for a melodious reason. We have gathered today to listen to two renowned artists from Bangladesh, Ms. Farida Parveen and Mr. Abdul Ghazi Hakim. Ms. Parveen is also known as the Queen of Lalan Geeti. She was brought up in Kushtia, the place where the great Bengali poet saint Lalan Shah Fakir was born and practiced his sadhana through his songs. Farida ji has played a crucial role in restoring the quintessential elements of Baul tradition, which is imbibed in the simplicity of its approach. The approach of embracing joy derived from the enlightening understanding of the intimate relation between the body and the soul. She is recipient of several prestigious awards, including Fukuoka Asian Culture Prize, Ekushi Podok, which is one of the highest civilian awards in Bangladesh. Mr. Ghazi Abdul Hakim is one of the most famous flutists in the subcontinent. He's known for his phenomenal experiments in music, especially fusion of classical, folk, and Western music. He's also known for including flute instead of ektara as the prominent instrument in the Baul tradition. Mr. Hakim had the honor of playing flute in the House of Commons in London and Commonwealth Summit in Canberra. Our guest artist from Bangladesh will be accompanied by Mr. Mubarak Khan on tabla. Mr. Khan teaches music in DPS Mathura Road and has been also serving on the panel of Indian Council of Cultural Relations. We welcome all the three artists today. The unique feature of today's concert is that, along with Bangla songs, Ms. Parveen will be also singing Lalan Geeti's Hindi translation by Prof. Muchkund Dubey. Thus, it's a historic moment for both the artists and the listeners. Prof. Dubey is here with us, and he will be sharing his passion for Lalan Geeti that inspired him to translate those geetis into Hindi. It's an honor to welcome you here in this concert, sir. I also welcome IIC's director, Air Marshal Naresh Verma, guest from Bangladesh High Commission, Sahitya Academy, Indian Council for Cultural Relations, CSD's director, Ashok Pankaj, distinguished faculties from CSD, my dear colleagues, friends, and along with honorable guests who have joined us together to cherish this melodious afternoon. Now I request my colleague, Dr. Sushmita Mitra, to take charge of this concert. Thank you.
Thank you, Anamika. I must also thank you all for coming in spite of this scorching weather outside. But I'm sure the special program is going to soothe you down with the mystic philosophy, tunes of nature, and love for humanity. To share a few words on his book, Lalan Shah Fakir Ke Geet, I now invite the author, Professor Muchkund Dubey, President, Council for Social Development. Sir.
I join my colleagues in the CSD to welcome you all to this musical function. I would like to say a particular word of welcome to the Honorable Minister of Information of the Government of Bangladesh, Mr. Inu, who has come all the way from Dhaka to participate in the presentation of the first copy of this book to the President of India tomorrow in a function at the Rashtrapati Bhavan. With him have also come other distinguished personalities from Bangladesh, particularly Professor Anisu Zaman, who is perhaps one of the greatest authorities on art and culture of South Asia in the whole subcontinent. And it was in recognition of his stature in this field that the Government of India awarded him the Padma Bhushan. And he is here, but he perhaps might have just got into his room from the airport, and he can't be present at this function. And I also would like to extend a word of welcome to His Excellency, the High Commissioner of Bangladesh, who happens to be with us this afternoon. With these words, I would like to say a few words about Lalan Shah Fakir in general and my interest in translating his songs. I think Lalan Shah Fakir is pretty well known among the Bengali speaking persons across the border. He's not so well known in the Hindi speaking area. I think nevertheless, I would just make a few points to highlight his greatness as a songster, as a poet, as a sadhak, and also a few points about his belief. Firstly, let me start by saying that he's decidedly the greatest among the Bauls in the Indian subcontinent. The origins, there's a lot of controversy about the origin of the Bauls, but some authoritative sources trace it back to the 14th century. And from 14th century till today, when they are still active, he dominated the whole of the 19th century. A whole century he dominated. Born in 1770 and lived for 116 years after that. He composed hundreds of songs, some say 1,000 songs. And Annada Sankar Raya has said that there is no example in history where a poet or a song writer has devoted 100 years of active life to just doing that. According to Annada Sankar Raya, there is no example of this in history, of literature, anywhere in the world. His songs have inspired and enthralled millions of Bengalis over centuries, two and a quarter century. These songs are suffused with a bewildering variety of an abundance of poetic richness. Lalan Geeti today is a mainstream of Bengali folk music, more so in Bangladesh than in West Bengal, where it is clubbed together with Baul songs. songs were the means of his sadhana, his expression of his poetic genius, and the communication of his message to the people. His message has tremendous relevance in the contemporary world, which is full of strife, violence, and forced migration in hundreds of millions because of differences of religion, of sects within religion. And West Asia is the hotbed of this kind of turmoil. In this world, we also find a rise of narrow nationalism and chauvinism as seldom witnessed in recent decades. And this is not only true of India, but also in the United States and in many of the important countries of Europe. This is threatening to destroy the whole scheme of values that evolved over the past century and a half, mainly through the endeavors of the great people in Europe, but very much based on the spiritual traditions of other communities. Then we witness today intolerance of others' point of view and others' way of life, what they eat, what they believe in. I'm mentioning all these things because Lalan castigated all these things in a remarkably effective manner, and with sarcasm, which according to my knowledge of literature, of Indian literature, is matched only by Kabir and nobody else. Most of his poems are addressed to people or to himself, and they are put in the form of questions. And these questions are so telling, so sarcastic, and as to make them immediately effective. I give you the two lines of one of his poems in Bengali. He says, "Hote chau hajurer dasi, mone garod niye rashi rashi." He starts that poem. Do you want to become the devotee of the Lord with so much of poison in your heart? This is how the poem starts. I think that today Lalan songs have acquired remarkable relevance, and this is one of the reasons which inspired me to translate 105 of his songs. I was working on it for almost 2 years and a half, off and on, I tried my best to see, because songs were the essence of Lalan's contribution. I tried my best to ensure that they were sung, or they are sung now, in Hindi, in the same way as they are sung in Bengali. That's why I kept the total number of matras intact, and I tried to keep even the sequence of matras. And I'm glad to know that Farida Parveen and the Bansuri accompanist have endorsed that I have succeeded in doing so during the course of the practice that we are having last couple of days. I think you will be listening to these songs as Anamika has pointed out, by its best exponent in the subcontinent, that is Farida Parveen. And she's accompanied by Hakim, one of the most wonderful flute players of the subcontinent and perhaps the best in Bangladesh. Farida Parveen was partly responsible for my being drawn towards Lalan Shah Fakir. When I was posted in New York, since I was interested in Bengali, I had bought a few long playing records containing Bengali folk songs, and each of these records had one or two Lalan songs. And when I listened to them, I was very much moved by them. And when I went to Dhaka as India's High Commissioner, I saw that this was practiced there as a special branch of folk song, Lalan Geeti. And there were many exponents in the country, Farida Parveen being the topmost among them at that time. But there were several others extremely good in, I mean, the specialization of Bengali music in Bangladesh is so much that even Najrul and Mrs. Reba Som will bear me out. You have singers in Bangladesh who sing only his ghazals. And you have singers in Bangladesh who sing only his Islami songs. He composed hundreds of Islami songs. So this is the degree of specialization which Bangladesh musicians practice. And this is true of Lalan Geeti also, which I heard there. And another inspiration came, you know, I have this bad habit of, right from my childhood, of translating into Hindi anything I found to be of poetic greatness, whether it is from Sanskrit or from Bengali or from English. And when I was in class 8 or 9, I translated it in Hindi, Shelley's Ode to the West Wind. And then when I was in the first year of my BA, I re-sang the whole of Gitanjali in Hindi verse at a time when no poetry translation of Gitanjali was available. So this was just for my entertainment I used to do. So I did with Samsur Rahman when I reached Bangladesh, and Lalan Fakir. And I translated some 8-9 songs of Lalan Fakir. When Farida Parveen heard it, she got it put into a cassette in a specialized place and distributed among many, and even sang some of my Hindi songs through Bangladesh radio and TV. And that is my association with her. So when I had the contract of translating the whole book, translating it, many poems to constitute a book with the Sahitya Academy, it was she to whom I turned to get the texts, so that the selection represented the whole work of Lalan Fakir. My selection has songs which are inspired by Sufi thoughts, songs which are inspired by the Sahajiya Buddhism, Deha Sadhana. There are songs which are inspired by Vaishnavite Bhakti. There are songs which are just melodious prayer to God by the devotee. And so I have tried to, there are songs which are inspired by Islamic thoughts. 3 or 4 of them I have included in that. So I have tried to make it as representative as possible. And I am already becoming too long, but I would just put one thing that I would say, that I have written an introduction to these songs, which is 40 pages long. And apart from giving his life, his music, his sadhana, the origin of the bowels, the expansion of the bowels, all drawn from Bengali sources, because nothing available in Hindi, and very little in English. So all drawn from Bengali sources. But there are two sections which are my own contribution and which is not available even in Bengali. And one section is comparing Lalan with Kabir, which I have done with meticulous research into Kabir's poetry. And second is that I have tried to bring out the poetic beauty of the 105 songs that I have included, a kind of a practical criticism, as it is called in English literature. And I think that is a contribution which is not available even in Bengali. So this is about my introduction. My aspiration is that the songs become popular in the Hindi-speaking world. I think the Hindi-speaking population of India is more prone to some of the evils of modern world and modern society that I have just brought out, and particularly during the contemporary current period. And I think that it is these poems are even more relevant to them than to the Bengali-speaking people. And ultimately, it will be popular only through music. That's why I took the trouble of getting 20 songs sung by Farida Parveen and bring out a DVD, which has been, I have been assisted in it by ICCR, for which I am most grateful. So I hope I have already been too long, and I don't want to come between you and the musician. And I would conclude here with my deep thanks and gratitude to you all for coming here. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now, the historic moment we are waiting for. Lalan Geeti in two languages, Bangla and Hindi, by the famous folk singer from Bangladesh, Queen of Lalan Geeti, Ms. Farida Parveen. I also invite Mr. Ghazi Abdul Hakim for the mystic melody on flute, and Mr. Mubarak Khan for accompanying in tabla, Mr. Kishore Kumar Malhotra in keyboard, and Mr. Parveen Shethi in dholak and percussion. Please welcome them. We will require few minutes for setting up the instruments. Please bear with us. Thank you.
see.
আজকের এই মহতী অনুষ্ঠানে আমার পূজনীয় ব্যক্তি মুচকুন্দ দুবে, উনি লালন শাহজির গান হিন্দিতে তর্জমা করেছেন। আমার অনেক ত্রুটি হবে, অনেক ভুল হবে, তারপরেও বিদগ্ধ জনেরা নিশ্চয়ই আমাকে ক্ষমাসুন্দর দৃষ্টিতে দেখবেন। আমি এখানে আমার পূজনীয় আমাদের স্যার আছেন, আমাদের অ্যাম্বাসাডার আছেন, আমাদের মন্ত্রী মহোদয় আছেন, এবং আপনারা যারা এসছেন সকলেই আমাদের পক্ষ থেকে কৃতজ্ঞতা জানাচ্ছি সাইজির গান শুনবার জন্য, বাংলা এবং হিন্দি। আমি বাংলা দিয়েই শুরু করছি। যারা বাংলা ভাষাভাষী আছেন তারা তো বুঝতেই পারবেন, তারপর আবার হিন্দিতে করব, সেটুকু আমি চেষ্টা করব শুদ্ধভাবে বলবার জন্য। আমি প্রার্থনা আঙ্গিকের গান দিয়ে শুরু করছি। পারে লয়ে যাও আমার।
আমি একা রইলাম ঘাটে মানুষে বসি লোপাটে আমি একা রইলাম ঘাটে মানুষে বসি লোপাটে
Fakir Lalan
এবারে যে গানটি গাইছি বাড়ির কাছে আশিনগর এটি হিন্দিতে গাইছি আর কি ভুল ত্রুটি হলে মার্জনা করবেন
Thank you. Thank you.
গানটি গাইছি, সেটি পাখি কখন জানি উড়ে যায়, একটা বদ হাওয়া লেগে খাঁচায় পাখি কখন জানি উড়ে যায়।
পাখি কখন জানি
পাখি কখন জানি উড়ে যদি যেত জানো জংলা কভু পোষমানে না আগে যদি যেত জানো জংলা কভু
এবারে যে গানটি গাইছি সেটি হচ্ছে হিন্দিতে মিলন হোগা কিতনে দিন মে মেরে মন মানুষ কে সঙ্গ মে
Thank you.
मिलन होगा कितने दिन में, मिलन होगा कितने दिन में, मेरे मन मानस के संग में, मेरे मन मानस के संग में, मिलन होगा कितने दिन में, मिलन होगा कितने
Yeah. চলো।
এবারে গাজী আব্দুল হাকিম তার সুরের ছোঁয়ায় আপনাদেরকে একটু অনুপ্রাণিত করবেন, করবার চেষ্টা করবেন আর কি। যাই হোক, উনি এখন রাগ ভূপালী, ওর ওর যে ওর নিজস্ব যে ঘরানাটা সেটি হচ্ছে ওয়েস্টার্ন, ইস্টার্ন এবং লোকগানের যে সমন্বয় সেটি ওর নিজস্ব প্রাধান্য আর কি। আমার মনে হয় আশা করি আপনাদের ভালো লাগবে।
Thank you.
আপনাদের একটুও ভালো লেগেছে, আর ভালো না লাগলে সেটি তার অক্ষমতা, আর ভালো লাগলে আপনাদের মহত্ত্ব। এবারে আমি যে গানটি গাইছি, পারে কে যাবি নবীর নৌকাতে আয়, আমাদের মুচকুন্দ দুবে স্যারের ভীষণ পছন্দের একটি গান। তো উনি বসে আছেন, উনি গানগুলো এত কষ্ট করে রচনা করেছেন, ওনার জন্য এই গানটি যদি না গাই আপনাদেরও আশা করি ভালো লাগবে। 20টা গান গাওয়া, আমি খুব নগণ্য ব্যক্তি, খুবই নগণ্য, কিন্তু গান করতে গিয়ে বুঝলাম গান গাওয়া অনেক কঠিন, সহজতর নয়। এই গানটি শোনাচ্ছি। Thank you.
সরা নিয়ে যারা তুফানে বদর গাজি থাকবে কোথায় পারে কে যাবি নবীর নৌকাতে ওই পারে কে যাবি নবীর নৌকাতে
Thank you.
এবারে হিন্দিতে যে গানটি গাইছি সেটি হচ্ছে খাঁচার ভিতর অচিন পাখি পিঞ্জরে কে ভিতর অঞ্চিনা পাঞ্ছি কেসে আয়ে যায়।
ना होता kapel kapel na hota panchi ka na hota yo vyavahar ki jula tadko panchi mera jula tadko panchi mera kis jagah ud ja kaise aaye jaaye pinjre ke bheetar anchi na panchi kaise aaye
বাংলা যেটা গাইছি সেটি হচ্ছে তিন পাগলে হলো মেলা নদী এসে
Bye. পাগলামি করে যাতাই সেই অজাতে রে দৌড়ে গিয়ে পাগলামি করে যাতাই সেই অজাতে রে দৌড়ে গিয়ে আবার হরি বলে পড়ছে ঢলে ধুলার মাঝে আবার হরি বলে পড়ছে ঢলে ধুলার মাঝে ওরে মন নারকোলের মালা তাতে জল তোলা ফেলা করম গোসে একটা নারকোলের মালা তাতে জল তোলা ফেলা করম গোসে পাগলের সঙ্গে যাবি পাগলের নামটি এমন বলিতে ফকির লালন হয় তার আসে পাগলের নামটি এমন বলিতে ফকির লালন হয় তার আসে
এবারে যে গানটি গাইছি লালন শাহজির হিন্দিতে আশাপূর্ণ হলো না আমার মনের বাসনা আশা পুরি হুই না মেরি আর না মন কামনা
और ना
sa puri hui na meri aur na mana kamana
শেষ করব স্যার
Woo!
বেদনায় মিলন বিরহ সংকট এই পদ্মা এই মেঘনা এই যমুনা সুরমা নদীত এই পদ্মা এই মেঘনা এই যমুনা সুরমা নদীত
Thank you.
তোমরা ভুলেই গেছো না শেষ স্যার ওই যে এক শ্রোতা কি বলছেন তোমরা ভুলে গেছো মল্লিকা দীর পথের মাঝে পথারালে আর কি পাওয়া যায় পথের মাঝে পথারালে আর কি পাওয়া যায় তোমরা ভুলে গেছো মল্লিকাদির নাম তোমরা ভুলে গেছো মল্লিকাদির নাম সে এখন ঘুমটা পড়ো আজকে আজকে যারা সঙ্গত করলেন এনারা খুব প্রতিথজশা এবং খুব আমার পূজনীয়। মোবারক হোসেন খান তবলায় ছিলেন, প্রবীণ ঢোলক এবং পার্কিশনে ছিলেন, কিশোর চাচা উনি ছিলেন কিশোর কিবোর্ডে ছিলেন, আর মাইক্রোফোনে এখানকারই নিশ্চয়ই সকলের প্রতি, আর আপনারা যারা কষ্ট করে এতক্ষণ অশ্রাব্য শুনলেন যেটা বলি আর কি, সেটি আমার জন্য অনেক বড় পাওয়া হলো। আর দোয়া করবেন যেন স্যারের আশাটা পূর্ণ করতে পারি আমরা। আর এখানে আমাদের অ্যাম্বাসাডার ছিলেন, আমাদের মন্ত্রী ছিলেন, সবাই আমার যে লিটু ভাই, আমাদের খুব প্রীতির, প্রীতির মানে কি একবারে আপন ভাইয়ের থেকেও বেশি করেন উনি সবসময়। আর আমাদের অ্যাম্বাসির যারা আছেন সকলের প্রতি, আপনাদের সকলের প্রতি আমাদের পক্ষ থেকে, আমি আর গাজী আব্দুল হাকিম আমরা দুজনেই এসেছি, এনারা আমাদের সাথে এই রেকর্ডিংয়ে বাজাচ্ছেন, সকলের জন্য আপনারা দোয়া করবেন, আপনারা ভালো থাকবেন, সুস্থ থাকবেন, সুস্থ গান শুনবেন, লালন সাহজিকে মনে রাখবেন। সকলকে আমাদের পক্ষ থেকে আবারও কৃতজ্ঞতা এবং ভালোবাসা জানিয়ে শেষ করছি। শুভ বিকাল।
We are virtually taken to a different world altogether. Before we come out of the trance, I invite Professor Ashok Pankaj, Director, Council for Social Development, to facilitate the artist. Please give a big hand for Ms. Farida Parveen. Mr. Ghazi Abdul Hakim. Mr. Mubarak Khan. Mr. Kishore Kumar Malhotra, and Mr. Parveen Shetty. At the end, I call upon retired Air Marshal Naresh Verma, Director, India International Center, for the vote of thanks.
Professor Muchkund Dubey, President, Center for Social Development, Mr. Hasanul Haq Inu, Honorable Minister of Information, Government of Bangladesh, Mr. Anisuzaman, Chairman, Bangla Academy, Bangladesh, and His Excellency, Mr. Abdul Khair Littu, High Commissioner of Bangladesh. Ladies and gentlemen, you will all agree that it has been a most magical and sublime afternoon. All of you who braved the scorching heat to take the trouble of coming here will surely find yourself well compensated as you go back with your hearts and souls filled with coolness of the mystical bowl songs of Lalan Fakir. It has been a pleasure for the India International Center to collaborate with Center for Social Development. As Anamika mentioned in the beginning, we are sister organizations and normally collaborate on intellectual events such as the annual Durgabai Deshmukh lecture or the commemoration of Bandung conference. But this melodious collaboration has been very fruitful and satisfying. It is my privilege now to extend our thanks for this event to all those involved. First of all, I thank Professor Muchkund Dubey for writing this book, because of which not only this event took shape, but for times to come, the eternal humanism and ascetism of Lalan Shah Fakir will be accessible to Hindi-speaking readers also. His words have a universality and timelessness. Sab poochte Lalan Fakir, Hindu ya Musalman, Lalan kahe pata nahi mujhe meri hi pehchan. Thank you, sir, for your laborious efforts of 2.5 years and giving us this book. The most fascinating part, as Mr. Dubey mentioned, that he has given a comparison of Kabir and Lalan, whereas Kabir's god was Avigat, Akat, Achintya, Anupam, and Lalan's god was Nigud, Nirgam, Alaksha. I thank Farida Parveen ji for this virtuoso rendering of Lalan's song. I think she deserves a huge round of applause. It was our privilege indeed to have the Queen of Lalan Geeti to sing at the India International Center. I thank the other musicians, Ghazi Abdul Hakim, flute, Mubarak Khan on tabla, KK Malhotra, Kishore Malhotra ji on keyboards, and Parveen Sethi, dholak and percussion. Parveen ji, ye naam aaj hi ke liye aapne rakha hai. Thanks to the entire team of CSD and the program division of IIC, headed by Premola Ghosh, for their coordination and efforts. Of course, Anamika and Sushmita for anchoring this program so beautifully. And lastly, thanks to all of you ladies and gentlemen in the audience for coming in such large numbers and making this function a success. Thank you.
Please join us for the tea outside. Thank you.